Hey, and welcome to Ahrefs Monthly Product Updates. We have a ridiculous amount of updates to introduce this month, 17 in total. Let's start with Brand Radar. Brand Radar is officially out of beta. We have three updates here. First, the big one we've all been waiting for, LLM indexes. Now you can track brand mentions in ChatGPT and Perplexity. We're also adding Gemini soon. Let's do a quick search for Pokemon in our ChatGPT index. And here we go. The types of questions people are asking in ChatGPT that relate to Pokemon. All very valid questions. We have data for 2 months for LLM indexes and plan to update monthly. Next, also new, tracking search demand via our new keywords index. This one shows you the total search volume for all keywords related to a brand. Search demand translates into brand awareness. So if your share of search isn't growing, your brand's revenue pipeline is probably fading. Third, we've also added an author filter under web visibility. Before, you could only search for articles with a specific author. But now, you can also filter for pages that either have an author detected or don't have an author. Some pricing changes now that Brand Radar is out of beta. AI Overviews, ChatGPT, and Perplexity indexes are available as paid add-ons at $99 per month per index, while Search Demand is included in any paid Ahrefs subscription. Moving on to web analytics, three updates to talk about here. First, custom events. This sounds fancy, but it just means you can track interactions like button clicks, form submissions, and other specific actions. For example, to see which pages drive signups, just track the signup click as a custom event, then filter for it. Setup simple, just add special class names to your HTML. I'll leave a link to instructions below. Next up, funnels. They're like an extension to events. Layer events and stack on any filters you like, and build funnels to see how visitors move through key steps on your site. This is amazing for seeing where visitors fall off and boosting your conversions. Each funnel supports up to 6 steps, and you can see things like how many users go from homepage to pricing to sign up, or product page to cart to checkout, or blog post to sign up to first in-app action. And lastly, now you can click and drag across the timeline in your charts to zoom into a specific date range. It's a quicker way to look at key periods and zoom into trend details. Moving on to AI Content Helper. We've introduced Brand Kits, which are a new way to keep your AI-generated content consistent and on-brand. Just add your brand URL, and we'll generate a kit with AI. It includes key info about your voice, tone, and writing style. You can attach a brand kit when creating a doc, or edit later on from any article settings. You can also drop one into your chat context manually. Moving on to a new tool, Google Profile Monitor. Find it under local SEO in your navigation bar. This tool lets you track changes to your Google business profiles, the listings you see in search and maps. You can stay on top of those changes and reject the ones you don't want. It's in beta and available on all paid plans, no limits. Just connect your Google account and import your locations to get started. Moving on to Site Explorer, three updates here. First, there's a new AI Detector tab in Page Inspect. It shows you how much of a page's content was likely AI generated. It also highlights the AI written parts and even guesses which LLM was used. We're bringing this to Site Audit next, so you'll be able to scan all your pages for AI content at scale. On to our second update. In the never-ending quest to combat spammy backlinks, we've added a new spam badge and a new filter to help clean things up. Go to any backlinks report or Site Explorer's overview chart, then open the best links dropdown and select non-spammy links. You can also make this your default view from best link settings. The filter is powered by a curated list of spammy domains, which we'll keep updating regularly. Next, some big upgrades to the history charts in overview. The organic keywords and intent charts now use a position-based view by default. Instead of counting just unique keywords, we now count every ranking position. So if you rank for multiple positions for the same keyword, or if you rank in multiple locations, each one is counted. That means higher totals, especially for big sites. Also, these charts load faster and handle large domains more efficiently. Moving on to Site Audit. We've made some big improvements to managing patches, especially if you're managing hundreds of pages. First up, there's a new patches dropdown in Page Explorer. Filter pages by patch status, like drafted or published, and export patches directly. including AI-generated titles and meta descriptions. On top of that, you can now bulk publish or unpublish patches in the patches report. Perfect for pushing out batch AI changes at scale without doing it one by one. Moving on to Keywords Explorer. Meet the new trending keywords filter that helps you spot rising keywords based on how they've grown over 3, 6, or 12 months. Filter by trend type, linear for steady growth, exponential for viral spikes, S-curve for seasonal topics, and damped for trends that have already peaked. Once applied, results are sorted by slope, so you'll see the fastest risers first. Moving on to Report Builder. Two additions here. GSC keyword widgets are now available. This includes top keywords by clicks, last, winners, losers, and new. Just like in the GSC overview report, bonus, you can also control how many results each widget shows. We've also added share of voice and share of traffic value widgets from Site Explorer, complete with history charts. Moving on to GSC reports. There's a new widget that shows clicks and impressions by position group for your selected time period. Want to see which keywords are in each group? Just check the keywords column for a quick breakdown. Moving on to our final update for API. We've added 5 new API endpoints for Rank Tracker. The previous batch let you retrieve data like projects, keywords, and competitors. And now, this new set lets you modify them. You can do things like create projects, add keywords to a project with specified locations and tags, or add or delete competitors. With these, enterprise users can now fully automate Rank Tracker project setup and keyword management. I'll leave a link to our API documentation below. And we are done for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our Canny. See you in the next update and have a great day.